Greetings from the CAST program. My name is Grace Yu, an Associate Program Coordinator with ETS. The purpose of this short video is to demonstrate the login processes for the California Alternate Assessments. First, I'll show you how to complete the Survey of Student Characteristics. Next, I'll show you how to start a test session. I'll show you the screens you'll see once you are in the system. This video assumes that you already have a username and password, and that you have the correct version of the directions for administration in hand. The DFAs are both version-specific and grade-specific, and they can be downloaded from the help folder from within TOMS. Make sure you have the right version that was assigned to your school. This is what a DFA looks like. In this case, grade 11 version 2. This is a printed copy of the DFA, but you can also use the DFAs electronically on a device that is separate from the device used for student testing. Remember, these are secure documents because they contain live test material. If you are missing either your login or DFA, contact your CAST test site coordinator. Also, test examiners must complete the CalAlt test administration tutorial and submit the resulting certification to their site coordinator before administering the CalAlt test to students. Now, let's take a look at the online testing system. Open your preferred browser. In this case, I am using Google Chrome. Type www.caaspp.org in the top navigation bar and select the Test Administrator Interface button. Once the login screen appears, you can type in your username and password. Then select the Login button. After you have logged in, you'll see the test selection window pane for all of the available tests. Expand the CAA test selection tree. In the CAA selection tree, you'll see three tests: the Survey of Student Characteristics, the CAA ELA test, and the CAA math test. The first test is not a test. It's actually the Survey of Student Characteristics, or SSC, that the test examiner is required to complete based on their familiarity with the student prior to administering a CalAlt, ELA, or math test. To complete the SSC, the test examiner must select it in the TA interface and then complete it on a separate device that has the CASP secure browser. And I'll show you exactly how to do that in the next couple of steps. Select the test that you want to administer from the test selection screen. For demonstration purposes, I'll be selecting all three CAA choices. Select the Start Operational Session button. On the upper right-hand corner of the TA interface, you'll see that the session ID has been generated. And now switch over to the student testing device that has the secure browser installed. Launch the secure browser. Type in the first name of the student typed exactly as it appears in CalPads, then type in CA followed by a hyphen, followed by the student's SSID number, then type in the session ID that was generated on the TA interface. Select the Sign In button. Next, you will be prompted to confirm the details of the student you are testing. Select Yes if the information is correct. You'll see all the available tests for the student to take. Note that the math and ELA options are grayed out, and the reason for this is that the SSC must be completed by the test examiner prior to administering the math and ELA test. We'll have a PDF version of the SSC on the About CAA page on CASP.org for the test examiner to look at before logging into this interface. Select the CAA SSC option. Go back to your test examiner device, and in the TA interface, verify that you have selected the correct tests and test settings for the student by selecting the Approvals button. Select Approve. Go back to the student testing device and select Yes, Start My Test to begin the survey. Select Begin Test Now. Answer the questions in the SSC based on your knowledge of the student. Again, you will be able to download a copy of this survey on the About CAA page, and you can mark what answers you will choose beforehand to expedite this process. Once you finish, select End Test. You'll be asked to confirm. Then select Submit Test, and you'll be asked to confirm again. Next, select the Log Out button. And now I'll show you the procedures on how to start a CAA, ELA, or math test. Follow the same procedures to log in to the student testing interface. Verify that you have the correct student, then select Yes. On the test selection screen, you'll notice that SSC is grayed out, and now the math and ELA test can be selected. Note that the SSC, the ELA test, and the math test can only be completed once for each student. Now choose the test you want to administer first. In this case, I'll be choosing ELA. Go back to the test examiner device. Select the approvals button. Select the approve button to begin testing. Go back to the student testing device and administer the assessment using the DFA script. This concludes the CAA testing demo. Remember to use the DFAs to administer tests to students and refer to other training resources and manuals on CASP.org for more information. Thank you and good luck with testing.